Alpha-lipoic acid, or ALA, is the real reason why broccoli is healthy. And we discovered it in 1937 when scientists found that certain germs reproduce with potato juice. Interesting, right? But ALA is also made by the body. The main job it does is to convert glucose into energy using oxygen, and we all know that as aerobic metabolism. But arguably one of the most important things it does is protect the body from free radical damage. It's an antioxidant with unique properties, mainly because of these special sulfur groups which make a diethylene ring, which we'll get into. But in this video, I wanted to talk about what alpha-lipoic acid is used for, how it works, how much to take, and some safety tips when using it. So stay with me till the end. Also, real quick, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Let's talk about why alpha-lipoic acid is unique. The first is because it's both water and fat soluble, which allows it to work in a lot more cells in the body. Vitamin C is only water soluble and vitamin E is only fat soluble, but ALA is both. The mitochondria makes a small amount of it every day, and foods like broccoli, spinach, tomatoes, and red meat contain it as well. But supplements can contain up to 1,000 times more ALA than food, which is why people like to supplement it. Find it used for nerve function, diabetes, weight, inflammation, and interestingly, anti-aging, as it's found that topical ALA helps fight wrinkles. But I wanted to talk about one of the most documented and researched use cases for alpha-lipoic acid, which is diabetic neuropathy. Interestingly, in Germany, lipoic acid has already been approved for this reason since 1966. And did you know that there's at least 25% of diabetics that are affected by some type of neuropathy, distal symmetric polyneuropathy being a specific one? And we have literature from 2010 that looked at this. Treatment with alpha-lipoic acid increases reduced glutathione, an important endogenous antioxidant. In clinical trials, 600 milligrams of alpha-lipoic acid has been shown to improve neuropathic deficits. That's exciting. My favorite one that was fun to read was the Aladdin 2 trial that took 509 subjects over 7 months who received either 600 milligrams of alpha-lipoic acid or placebo, right? While no significant difference was noted in subjective symptom evaluation among the groups, treatment with alpha-lipoic acid was associated with improved nerve function. Incredible. And it's important that you know how it works too, so let's talk about it. It has to do with nitric oxide. Remember that video I made about circulation where we talked about nitric oxide enhancing foods? Well, there's this process called nitric oxide endothelium dependent vasodilation. Once this is enhanced, you get improvement in microcirculation. You increase microcirculation, you'll get more nutrients and antioxidants to the nerves to help clean things up. Especially important when it comes to diabetic feet and diabetic eye issues, because this is where blood circulation is tight and blood flow is hard to reach. And remember how we mentioned these sulfur groups from earlier? Well, it turns out that this group in particular is what eliminates the reactive oxygen species by reducing the oxidized forms of other antioxidants. Now, in layman's terms, that just means ALA regenerates other antioxidants such as vitamin C and E, as well as glutathione, the mother of all antioxidants. So that's the first application, nerve pain. The second one is how ALA is also studied extensively for insulin resistance, which seems to be a big issue these days. We're lucky to have a systematic review and meta-analysis with a total of 24 studies that looked at this. The findings of this meta-analysis show that ALA supplementation among patients with metabolic diseases significantly decreased fasting glucose, insulin, HOMA-IR, and hemoglobin A1C. Now, researchers are investigating how it works exactly to do this, but one idea that's fascinating is the role it plays on heat shock proteins, specifically HSP27, which I can discuss in future videos if you like, because I think that heat shock proteins are just a fascinating subject on their own. So those were the first two reasons why someone would take ALA, nerve pain and insulin resistance. Thirdly, it may also be beneficial in inflammation, specifically inflammation caused by CRP or C-reactive protein. And what do I mean? There are many factors that affect this protein in our body. One interesting one is how socioeconomic status plays a role in it as well. Levels of CRP increase when there's inflammation, sometimes 1,000-fold, and the levels go down when inflammation is improved. That's why it's an important biomarker that you can use to gauge the level of inflammation. Is it possible that ALA can reduce CRP? That's hard to say, but there is some robust research on it. A systematic review and meta-analysis of a randomized controlled clinical trial from a total number of 508 studies, they used 11 with 264 participants in supplementation groups and 287 in control groups. Estimated pooled random effect size analysis showed a significant reducing effect of alpha-lipoic acid supplementation on CRP level with a significant heterogeneity between the selected studies. Now again, more research is needed, but the future for this looks bright. But how much ALA to take? That's the next question. Generally, the dose is 600 to 1200 milligrams daily. Now there is a trick to this. It's best taken on an empty stomach as certain foods can lower the acid's bioavailability. Ideally, 2 hours after eating or 30 minutes before eating is when you should take ALA. And you can also find a link to the one that I like in my Thorn store where you can get alpha lipoic acid 300 milligrams. It's super high quality product backed by extensive research and formulated with clean, potent ingredients like all their products are. You can also shop my entire supplement collection as well as find my top three favorite supplements. And keep in mind, the higher doses of ALA are not recommended as it doesn't provide any extra benefits. Sticking within that range is ideal. And in terms of safety, some people may experience low blood sugar with it, which is why it's a good idea to let your doctor know before you take it to make sure that you are the right candidate for it. There are some interactions with ALA and chemo medicines, thyroid medicines like levothyroxine, and if you're low in B1 from alcohol or other causes, your doctor can then assess whether or not the benefits outweigh the risks for these conditions. Also, if you take an ALA topical cream, make sure you do a spot test first, as some have been reported to cause skin rashes. And one last thing, sometimes you will search ALA online and get alpha-linolenic acid to pop up. Alpha-lipoic acid is not the same thing as alpha-linolenic acid. Alpha-linolenic acid is an omega-3 fatty acid used for other conditions, so keep an eye out for that difference. But I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys. What are your thoughts on alpha-lipoic acid? Leave them in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, give it a like so that I know. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.